Today we're talking about chip and dips. And why are they a chip and dip and not a dip and chip? I have no idea. A question for another day. But when most people think about a chip and dip set, they think about something that looks like this. I don't. In this video, I'm going to show you how I make a chip and dip differently and why. If you do want to know how to make this chip and dip or one very much like it, please watch to the end and I'll show you. But right now what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut this off, wedge it up, and show you how I make a chip and dip. So I've got it centered, flattened, and all those particles aligned. I'm just going to open up slightly. You want to make sure when you open up, I'm just bending my finger over. And I'm just going to open up a little bit. I'm going to switch and put my left hand in there. So what's happening here is my left hand is pulling across. My middle finger is doing the pulling. But under my hand, my thumb is keeping this edge in check. And it's going to pull. And if it goes a little off center, just hold yourself firm and it'll go back on again. Sometimes it likes to wiggle a little bit. Not a big deal. Also, as you're pulling your platter across, clay has its own rhythm and its own speed. Just let it go. There, it went a little bit wonky. Hold firm. And notice the wheel's not going that fast. Now I'm getting close to the edge here. So when I can reach my thumb there, I'm going to go from holding it this way, so I'm holding it this way, to that way. And I'm pushing down with a little finger on my right hand, keeping everybody all in check. I like when I'm throwing a platter, one, to have some thickness in the bottom, and it's easier to make the bottom thinner than it is to make it thicker. Okay, so now I'm just gonna pull this up a little bit. And now I got this messy bottom, I'm gonna go inside and clean that up. When you open a platter, you have to work the bottom quite a bit. So if you leave thickness there, every time you compact and go back and forth, it gets a little bit thinner. I always have a thin spot there. I'm gonna push that out. And now I'm just going to level the bottom of that platter. I'm going to do all the work on the inside of this plate or platter before I work on the outside. When I make a chip and dip, I like to throw a platter. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to throw like a saucer, like a cup and saucer holder in the middle. And then I'm going to throw a couple of bowls. I find when you throw, when you make them with the bowls attached, you don't have a lot of options. Your chip and dip is a chip and dip. Now with the bowls separate, this can be a platter or a serving plate without any dip. Also, you can, it doesn't take much room in the cupboard. It's not deep like a chip and dip has that big bowl in the middle. And when you do put this in the dishwasher, it doesn't take up nearly as much room as the bowl attached ones. So what I'm doing is I'm throwing just a little, like a little, as I said, the cup and saucer, a little ring inside to hold the bowl. Now that's why you want to make sure you start off with enough clay in the bottom, because you're going to turn this over and trim it a bit, so you don't want it to get too thin. So I'm just going to work this, and I get everything on the inside done. I think I want that a little bit bigger. And you want to make sure when you're doing this that the inside of this bowl holder is level, because your bowl will rock. And I know your pottery rocks, but you don't want it to rock, if that makes sense. So that's level. Tidy that up. And then I'm going to pull this up into... Now this point, when I came into the video, I had a bowl. You can make this a bowl. I prefer to make it a plate, just because I like it and you're allowed to like what you like. So I'm going to flatten this out into a plate. There's a few ways to make a plate. I like to make mine with a big rib, but you can just pull that out into a plate. Now I'm going to take a chance because I'm going to pull this out into a plate. I'm going to stand it up and then use a rib on it. So if you are going to make it a plate, I don't like to make it a really flat plate because you do want it to hold all the goodies. And also, since I'm going to stand this back up, I'm not going to flatten it right out. But I am going to flatten it out, pull it back into a bowl so I can show you how I use my big rib. If you want to make your own rib, there is a link to a video below, a short that shows you all the measurements, and I like this guy because you can get a hold of it. I'm just going to go in there and flatten that. Make sure that's a nice groove there. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to call this done. You have to watch when you're drying these, that there's a lot of times that they have to dry slowly. What'll happen is these edges, if they dry quickly, will dry first and they'll shrink and they'll pull up, and they never pull up level, so your dish is like this. So dry it slowly. If it does happen to warp, that one side's a little bit higher, you can put it on the wheel, and the side that's a little bit higher, where's my little sponge? You can just lower that side when you're trimming, and then throw it flat. So that works well too. Sometimes you can put some marks in here and your glaze will break on those, and that can look kind of cool. So now you've got your platter, but you don't have your bowl. So I will take this off. I won't roll this one up. And I will throw a couple of bowls off the hump to show you how they go together as a set. When I make a chip and dip, I like to make two bowls. I like to make them off the hump. I like to make two bowls because, one, you can have sour cream and salsa, you can have more than one kind of dip, you can break one, still have a set. And I've got a video in the links below on how to throw off the hump, how to throw bowls off the hump. So I'm just going to do this one quickly. I don't bother to measure the ring in the platter when I'm making these, because I usually make a batch of them, and then I make a batch of little bowls and trim them all up. These are coming off the hump; they're not that big. So, anyway, so if you trim them all up and you got a batch of bowls and a batch of platters, they all line up. And if you have extra condiment bowls, sell well. So I'm just going to make a little bowl, and I'm going to just put my thumb in. I just pull my thumb to the palm of my right hand. Now when I'm making a bowl, I don't like to make it too stingy. I like my dip. And I don't like to make them too thin. They're going to be used a lot. Well, in my life, they're going to be used a lot. And they're going to go in the dishwasher and the microwave, and they're going to be used around. So kitchen bowls, I like to throw with a little bit of weight to them. It's not perfect on top. I'm going to make it tidy. And I'm going to give it one more pull. And as I say, I don't measure them. After you've made bowls for a while, they all come out to be about the same size. I'll make another one and see if that's true. So bowl number one. And I'm going to, when this is dry, I'll turn it upside down and trim it. Now I want to take it off there, but I'm going to take a little bit of this extra. You can quite easily pick that bowl up and not wreck it. But I like to have the stuff on the bottom just in case. If you're going to stick your fingers into it, you might as well stick it into the clay on the bottom and not into the bowl. And this stuff can be recovered quite quickly and still wedged up and put back in the process. So now I'm just going to stick my thumbs in there and pick it up and not wreck my bowl. I always like to put it on a board with a piece of paper. Sometimes it will stick to the board. And if the paper's there to stick to the paper, it doesn't matter because it peels off. So we're going to do another one. Let's see if they're the same. They're close. Anyway, those will dry out and I'll trim them up. And that's how I do a chip and dip. I said I like them. They fit in the cupboard. They fit in the dishwasher. And it's my way. Come back and I'll show you how I make the one with the bowl attached. I'm going to open this. This is much the same. I did a video in the links below on how to throw a donut vase. Like how to throw a, well, a donut vase. A closed vessel. And this opens much the same. And you have to watch. It's surprising it takes a lot of clay to make the bowl in the middle. So if you start separating it there, you're not going to have enough clay. So I'm going to start it there. It's always better to have too much. It's always better to have too much of anything than not enough. So I'm just going to open it here. And what I'm going to do is I'm not going to let that top get away. When you push down, it likes to get away. And I'm going to push down and be careful because this is the bottom of your bowl. So you don't want to let it get too thin. As I said, in throwing the bowls off the hump, a lot of times you have issues. Well, we'll get to issues after we're done. Okay, I'm just going to pull this open the same way I did the plate. I can reach, so my thumb's on the outside and my hand is compressing down. And I'm pulling at the speed the clay wants to go the bowl open. Then what I do when I get to here, under my hand as I bring that thumb forward and blend all the clays, the outside and the inside together, as nice as a chip and dip is, you don't want it appealing. So. And like the platter chip and dip, I'm going to get this open to the size I want, and then I'm going to work on the middle, and then I'll go out and make the bowl. So now I've got, I'm just going to flatten this out a little bit. Okay, so now I've got the clay for the bowl in the middle. I'm going to center this piece. And this is where people get problems. When you throw this bowl, you can have a lot of clay ending up here and your thin bottom there. It just causes a lot of stress and thick and thin. So that's another reason why I don't like these guys. However, you're allowed to like what you like. So I'm just going to throw this. I'm just throwing a bowl in the middle of this. But I'm working together that way, pulling my fingers together. And pulling it up into a bowl. I got enough water in there to swim. We'll get rid of some of that so I can see what's going on. Okay, so I'm just going to pull. Now what I like to do is once I kind of get the size, I'm just going to not undercut it, but put my finger in there and give the bowl some definition. Okay, so it's almost done. I'm going to go on the outside now. Now you can make this a bowl, you can make it a plate, you can make it what you like. I'm going to make it a bowl because most people think about a chip and dip bowl. It's not quite level. Level it off. Give it a little bit of flare. And what I'll do is I'll level this one off. And make the profiles match just because I want to. So that's how I don't make a chip and dip. If you have liked watching me make my chip and dips, please hit the like button. If you want to tell me which one you like better, if you like this one or the plate with the separate bowls, you can please let me know in the comments below. If you have any other suggestions or comments or questions, I would love to hear from you. And thanks ever so much for watching.